these appropriate theorems, either Gauss, Green's and Stokes, we may able to evaluate the equivalent integral very easily. That means we'll convert the surface integral to some other integral. It can be a line integral, it can be a surface, I mean a volume integral also, based on the given definition of cost type. So that would be easy. Instead of surface integral, same we will solve some other integral, maybe volume integral, maybe the line integral, okay, by making some conversion. That would be easy and both the results will be same. That is what we are going to do here now. Okay, so in that, out of three theorems, the first one is Gauss divergence theorem. Gauss divergence theorem. Okay, so what does this theorem says? Let us see. And of course, we are not going to prove any one of this theorem. It is out of beyond your scope. Just you need to learn these theorems and apply them while solving the problems. So this Gauss divergence theorem is actually a transformation . Is the writing visible properly?
Light, ma'am.
Chala light ga undi kada. I'll change it. Okay. So it's a transformation between. Now it's okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So I'm not rewriting this heading again. Just transformation between surface integral and volume integral. Okay, so Gauss divergence theorem is actually a transformation between the surface integral and the volume integral. So a problem given in surface integral can be converted to volume integral and evaluate the and get the solution. So comparatively, surface integral and volume integral, you can always solve the problem in an easy way by using the volume integral, as you have already done. You have done all three types of integral, but comparatively surface is more difficult. So we will convert the surface integral to volume integral by using this Gauss divergence theorem, which says that suppose you have a closed surface enclosing a volume V, and if F bar is a continuously differentiable vector point function, then the surface integral, which is given by F bar dot L bar ds, is it or not? This is the surface integral, and according to this theorem, the transformation is that you convert this into the volume integral by writing divergence of F bar dv, okay, and this is over the volume V. So this is nothing but a triple integral. Volume dv means what you have, though you have triple integral, whereas in surface integral you have double integral, but comparatively if you see, solving triple integral easy, is it or not, compared to this double integral based on that given surface, where this n bar, as all of you know, n bar is the outward drawn normal vector at any point of x. So this is the transformation, this is the Gauss divergence theorem. Okay, what is the transformation? You are transforming a surface integral to volume integral, and here you will write the evaluate the volume integral. The function is divergence of F bar. Divergence of F bar means what result f bar is a vector, but divergence of f bar will be a scalar value you are going to get. Is it or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, a scalar value. So for this scalar function, you have to evaluate three times with respect to x, y, and z. So let us see the same thing in the Cartesian form. If I write f bar to be some f1i, okay, in Cartesian form, suppose f bar is f1i plus f2j plus f3k. Okay, then the divergence theorem, the same theorem, I can write it as this one, this is surface integral, is it or not? So when I apply the surface integral with f1, I will have dy dz plus f2 dz dx plus f3 dx dy. Okay, at this three times, I mean for this one also double integral, for this also I need to double integral, for this also I need to double integral over the surface S, over the surface S. Okay, and this is same as that of equating the triple integral. Okay, now since what you are taking divergence of f bar, this is the surface integral what I have written, which by using divergence theorem in the form of Cartesian form, what is here, what I should have, divergence of f bar. F bar is written as f1i plus f2j plus f3k. So what will be divergence of f bar, tell me? It will be dou f1 by dou x, dou f2 by dou y, plus dou f3 by dou z. Will it be or not? Are you able to follow what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and this thing will be whichever order you want, accordingly you write. So now tell me which one is easy here to solve comparatively. The volume integral is easy to solve, integrating with respect to x, y, z by substituting the limits. Whereas here you have to go for all projection and all those things, whatever you have to do accordingly, you have to solve the surface integral. So this is called as Gauss divergence theorem, which is a transformation between the surface integral and the volume integral. Okay, now make a note here, though of course we are not going to prove them, but in case if they ask the result to be in this form. Okay, by using Gauss divergence theorem, you can also prove that the surface integral n bar cross f bar ds is equal to the volume integral del cross f bar dv. So whenever I write dv at a single integral over v, so this is nothing but the volume integral only a function here changed here. What is that? Del cross f bar, it is a curl of a vector, so again a vector only you are going to get, and this transformation you can make. Okay, this is f n bar cross f bar ds is a surface integral which you have converted to the volume integral. And the second one is again n bar phi, a vector multiplied with phi ds, and here n bar, as we know, it is a even normal vector. Okay, which will be equal to the volume integral del phi d. And one more important thing to be note here is you can apply Gauss divergence theorem is useful only for closed surfaces. Okay. Understood all of you Gauss divergence theorem?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now here the questions can be in two ways. They may give you some vector function and ask you to apply Gauss divergence theorem to evaluate the surface integral. Okay. Suppose, for example, suppose for example, two examples I'll write. Okay, they will give something like that. Use Gauss divergence theorem to evaluate the surface integral x dy dz plus y dx dz plus z dx dy, where they will mention what is s. S is x square plus y square plus z square, which is equal to a square. Okay, this is given to you. This means this whole thing is actually what? This is surface integral f bar dot n bar ds. Avna?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, which I have underlined. That is nothing but f bar dot n bar ds. This is the surface integral you have to solve. So if this statement is not mentioned using Gauss divergence theorem, then you would have integrated this by using all you by taking this surface and doing substituting the limits and whatever required, accordingly you solve it. Okay, since they have mentioned to apply Gauss divergence theorem, so this thing will be now equal to nothing but the volume integral divergence of f bar dv. Okay, that means the volume integral divergence of f bar you calculate, and dv is dx dy dz, and this limits you will get from the surface itself. Understood all of you? This is one type of question. Here in this question, you are not at all evaluating the surface integral, but you are using the Gauss divergence theorem. So instead of evaluating the surface integral, you are actually getting the volume integral by using this theorem. This is one question. Second question, same question I will give in this form also. Same question, I will, instead of using the word, I'll write verify Gauss divergence theorem. Something like this, verification word is given. Then in that case, what verification means? What we have to prove the statement, na? We have to prove that whether you solve the the surface integral, this particular part, or the volume integral by using this definition, both the results are same. LHS is equal to RHS. We need to prove. Understood all of you? Whenever they ask you, this is the verification will be quite lengthy question. Why it would be lengthy question? Because for the same problem you are evaluating the surface integral as well as the volume integral also. LHS also you are calculating, RHS also you are calculating. Got it? So whenever verification is given, you have to solve both the things. But whenever they ask you to just apply the Gauss divergence theorem to evaluate the surface integral, you just apply that theorem and convert the surface integral to volume integral and calculate the volume integral only. That is just the application part. Whereas verification means both the integrals you have to calculate and show that both the values are same. Okay? Now, I don't actually remember, from the surface integral you have solved a problem related to that cube. Verify some vector, evaluate the surface integral which is taken over for some given vector, which is taken over the surface of the cube bounded by x is equal to a, y is equal to a, z is equal to a. What is the vector there? Tell me. I remember you have done that kind of problem. Okay, leave it. Let us again solve and check. This will be a repetition of the same problem. But still, you will have practice. Those who have not present on that day, they can also understand. So here the verification is given. Verify Gauss divergence theorem for f bar is equal to x cube minus yzi minus 2x square yj plus zk, which is taken over. Is it the same vector I have given in the last class while solving the problem related to surface integral? Check it. Surface of the cube bounded by the planes x is equal to y is equal to z is equal to a and the coordinate planes. No answer. I'm asking something, but nobody is responding. Is it the same vector?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So, chapran kanta se padtadi. This is the question. They want you to verify Gauss divergence theorem. That means they have to solve both. They want you to solve both the surface integral and volume integral. So we need to prove this surface integral f bar dot n bar ds is equal to the volume integral divergence of f bar dv. We need to prove both LHS also we need to calculate, RHS also we need to calculate. So first what we will do is we will calculate the RHS part only because that would be easy. Is it or not? Calculating RHS part is easy, therefore we will just assume the RHS part, which is equal to the triple integral. Volume integral is the triple integral. Okay, what is divergence of f bar? Tell me. Divergence of f bar means del dot f bar. Del dot f bar means f bar is already given. You need to differentiate this function, which I am underlining, with respect to x, then this with respect to y, and then z with respect to z. So when I differentiate the first one, with the component with I with respect to x, I will get 3x square. With respect to y, the second component, I will get minus 2x square. Is it? And with respect to z, it will be 1. So overall, this is how much? It is just x square plus 1. So that is the value of divergence of f bar. So that is x square plus 1. Now, since it is the cube, the volume is bounded by these planes, x is equal to y is equal to z is equal to a, and the coordinate planes. So, in any order, I can integrate this one because all the limits are constants, 0 to a, 0 to a, 0 to a. So, evaluate this integral and tell me the result. With respect to x, if you integrate, you will get x cubed by 3 plus x, you will get limits 0 to a dy dz. So upper limit will be a cubed by 3 plus a, lower limit 0. So this constant outside. Now you integrate with respect to y, limit 0 to a. Limits, then you integrate with respect to z, 0 to a. So you will get a cube by 3 plus a as it is. This will be a into a square. So if you simplify it, what you will get? A to the power 5 by 3 plus a cube. Is it the answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So this was RHS. This was actually the volume integral, that is divergence of f bar dv. See how easy it is to calculate. Okay. But since they want you to verify, if the question was just to evaluate this surface integral based on these conditions, you can apply Gauss divergence theorem and within these four lines you will get the answer. This is our answer by applying Gauss divergence theorem. But now verification is also need to be done because they ask you to verify. So give the heading verification. For verification, what we need to calculate? We need to calculate the surface integral f bar dot n bar ds. This we need to calculate over the surface of the cube, which is bounded by those planes and the coordinate planes. Okay, so this is going to be quite lengthy one. So So that is z axis, or whichever axis you take, doesn't matter. X axis, this is z axis. You can give your name also. Okay. O, A, B, Q, P, S, C. Let this be R. So for over six surfaces, you need to calculate this value. Okay. So what I do, I'll just mention, you evaluate and tell me the answer. Suppose S1 I choose, which I'm taking it as P, Q, A, S. This kind of problem already we have done. Anna, P, Q, A, S I'm choosing. P, Q, A, S. This face I'm choosing. On this face, what is X value? Tell me. Fast.
A.
A. Now, what is the unit normal vector? It is?
I cap.
I cap. Very good. It is outside, na? So, unit normal vector is plus I cap. Okay. What will be ds? Ds will be?
Dy dz.
Dy dz. So, y will be between? Y and z both will be between? 0 and A. Therefore, F bar dot N bar we will calculate first. Whatever F bar you have, N bar is I cap, N bar is I cap, I bar. So you just take the dot product of F bar. So what is F here? F is X cube minus YZ. So if you take the dot product with I, you will get that term, which is X cube minus YZ. This is your f bar dot n bar. Now x cube, x value is already we know, that is a, so we will get a cube minus yz. Okay, therefore the surface integral over, you write double integral also doesn't matter, either you write it in this way or just a single integral, it doesn't make any difference. F bar dot n bar ds will be equal to now double integral 0 to a, 0 to a, the function is a cube minus yz here, f bar dot n bar, and ds is dy dz. That's over. In the denominator, what you need to write? N cap dot I cap only, na? But n bar is again I cap only, so the dot product will be 1. So this will be nothing but 0 to a, 0 to a cube minus yz dy dz. In any order you can integrate because the limits are constant here. So integrate it and tell me the answer.
A power 5.
A to the power 5.
Minus.
Okay.
Let a me power 4.
A to the power 5 minus A to the power 4.
By 4.
By 4. Okay.
Yes,
so this is answer for only one surface. We have to do the same for remaining five surfaces also. See, one surface chedanki the same pattindi. Overall, the volume integral directly by using the volume integral, that divergence theorem, in one time only we have got the answer. Whereas here we have to first calculate the surface integral for each of this surface and then add. Such a lengthy procedure. Okay, now go to the next one, the opposite of that one. S1 the opposite line, the opposite face.
OCRB.
Yeah, OCRB, this face. OCRB. So here, N bar will be equal to how much?
Minus I.
Minus I. Okay, and X will be?
Zero.
So here S2 is OCRB. Here N bar is I cap and X is 0. DS is again dy dz. And of course yz lies between 0 and A. So again you calculate F bar dot N bar, which is minus of F bar dot I cap, which will be minus of X cube minus yz, if I am not wrong. And this will be equal to how much, tell me?
Yz.
So I can see it's not the same problem, because last time when we solved at some surface your value was zero, is it or not? But here this is not happening. You have your yz as the function which you need to integrate. Okay, so therefore your s2, the integral over s2 f bar ds will be now equal to double integral yz dy dz 0 to a 0 to a. So integrate this also and tell me the answer.
A to the power 4 by 4.
Okay, so that is done. Now let us go to the third surface. You tell me, where is it? Okay. Now let us choose R, B, Q, P, front surface, front one, this one. So for this one, what will be the unit normal vector, tell me? It is?
K cap.
It is K cap. And here what will be your Z value?
A.
So let us write it. Huh. So for the third one, which I chose it to be the front face, which is R, B, Q, P. Here Z is equal to A. DS will be DX, DY. And N bar, we calculated, what was it? That is K cap. And X, Y, both are between 0 and A. So, first we need N bar dot F bar dot N bar, which is F bar dot K cap. And if I'm not wrong, F bar, the component with K was Z, na? So here what you will get? Only Z you will get. Itana? And since Z is equal to A, this value will be equal to A. Since Z is equal to A, therefore the surface integral F bar dot N bar, and don't write surface, it is the third face, okay, third. So DS will be now equal to the double integral A constant outside DX DY limits 0 to A, 0 to A. So even if you solve it, you will get A cube only. Antana? Okay, for x also A, for y also A, already A there out, so x cube. Okay, so that's the answer. Now, the opposite face, S4, you tell me what is the opposite face. You name it, here Z will be equal to 0, DS is DX, DY, N cap will be equal to minus K cap, and of course, XY will be between 0 and A. What is S4 tell me?
OASC.
OASC. So this again we need to calculate F bar dot N bar, which will be minus of F bar dot K bar, K cap, which will be minus Z, na? And which will be minus A. Then? Zero. Okay.
Zero.
Yeah. Zero. Correct. Here Z is zero. Yeah. So zero. So therefore, the value of the surface integral over the face S4, F bar dot N bar ds will be equal to zero. Now coming to the fifth one, S5. Front and back is done. Sides are done. What is left out? Bottom and top, na? So what is the topmost part? Tell me, name it.
CRPS.
CRPS, okay. CRPS. And here obviously your Y will be equal to A, and N bar will be equal to J cap. DS will be equal to DX, DZ, okay, na? And x, z will be between 0 and. Now calculate f bar dot n bar. F bar dot n bar which is f bar dot j cap. Okay, what is the component of f bar with j? F two empty akada?
-2x² y.
So if you take the dot product, you get -2x² y, and here y value is a, so you will get -2ax². So therefore, the surface integral is 5 kadadi. F bar dot n bar ds is now the double integral 0 to a, -2a outside, x² dx dz. So integrate it and tell me the answer here. You will get x³/3, so that is a to the power 4.
Minus.
Yeah, minus
2/3.
2/3.
A
to the power 5. Okay. One more is left out, that is S6. And what is that surface? Tell me. Where y will be equal to 0. Hi, name it.
OAQB.
OAQB. So here y will be obviously equal to 0. Your n bar will be equal to minus j. Ds is as usual dx dz, and x and z will be between 0 and a. So since this is minus, your f bar dot n bar, which is minus of f bar dot j bar, will be equal to 2x² y, na? But this result will be equal to 0, since y is equal to 0. So this value over S6, f bar dot n bar ds is equal to 0. So hence, the surface integral f bar dot n bar ds is the surface integral 1 plus S2 plus S3 plus S4 plus S5 plus S6. You write the remaining things also. So on S5, what we have got, tell me, please answer.
-2a/5/3.
S1.
a^5 - a^4/4.
Okay. S2.
a^4/4.
With a minus sign.
Plus.
On S2, is it plus you have got?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so that is plus a to the power 4/4, so cancelled. Then S3?
A cube.
S4? 0. S5?
-2a/5/3.
S6? 0.
0.
So this and this part cancelled. Simplify it, what you got, tell me?
a^5/3 + a³.
And is it not the same answer for what you have calculated the volume integral del dot f bar b?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So hence, Gauss divergence theorem is verified. So see how easy it becomes when apply the theorem, Gauss divergence theorem. Here verification is asked, therefore you had done both the parts, both RHS and LHS. But if the verification is not mentioned, and if they want you to solve the surface integral, you can use, even they don't mention, you can use the Gauss divergence theorem and just calculate the volume integral. See here, you have actually solved 6 integrals. You have actually solved 6 integrals and then add and then got the value. Whereas there, what we have done? There, just one simple triple integration we have done. Is it or not? With one of this, within 2 or 3 lines, how many lines required? Only within 3 lines you got the answer. Whereas for surface integral, for each surface, for each case, you have done this thing. Okay. So if verification is asked, You don't have the option but to solve both the RHS and LHS part, that is the surface integral as well as the volume integral. But instead of verification, if they asked you to apply Gauss divergence theorem and evaluate the surface integral, if they ask you apply Gauss divergence, even if they don't ask, you can go for it by mentioning that by applying Gauss divergence theorem, where this is the transformation. This transformation, the boxed one, you mentioned that by applying Gauss divergence theorem, we can solve this surface integral by this transformation, convert it into volume integral, and then solve it. Okay, understood all of you? Gauss divergence theorem?
Yes, ma'am.
But verification, mostly they will ask you to verify only lengthy question. So whenever verification is given, you don't have the option but to apply, but to solve both RHS and LHS part. Okay, write down this question. By the question can be in this way also, they won't mention any name and all, but indirectly they will ask you to apply Gauss divergence theorem by transforming into triple integral. So this is the only theorem where you are transforming a double integral kind surface to triple integral. So when I say triple integral, that means Gauss divergence theorem only you have to evaluate. Okay, evaluate x cube dy dz plus x square y dz dx plus x square z dx dy, where S is the closed surface consisting of the cylinder x square plus y square is equal to a square and the circular disk z is equal to 0, z is equal to b. This is given. Okay. Now they want you to convert it into the triple integral. That means this whole double integral, which is x cube dy dz plus x square y dz dx plus x square z dx dy, need to be converted to the triple integral. And since I'm talking about divergence theorem, so here this will be equal to divergence of f bar dv. Understood? Or maybe dx instead of writing dv, since I have already used triple integral sign, dx dy dz. This also, this part they want you to solve. Understood? But to solve this one, but to apply this theorem, you should have your f bar. Na? F bar is say it's not a big deal. Oh, big deal. All the limits are given. Z is 0 to b. Y you can write in terms of x, and x again a constant. You can do it. Okay. So limits is not an issue. But what will be your f bar? How you will calculate your f bar? Tell me. How you will calculate your f bar?
X cube y cap.
Acha.
Plus x square y. J cap. Plus x square z. K cap.
Is this your f bar?
No, ma'am. Dou f1 by dou x, dou f2 by dou y.
Very good. you if you have written or understood the things, starting itself I have given this one. Observe this one. In Cartesian form, everything is written here. So your F. So how you will calculate your F1, F2, F3? Comparatively, okay. What you said, F1, F2, F3, and your F bar is this one only. What you said? Just let me. Sorry. Come on. Okay, that is correct only, no? What as far is given. It's correct only, what is it? It is y, okay. F is given, you can calculate your divergence of f bar now. Okay, what will be divergence of f bar, tell me?
5x square.
5x square, good, sorry. Sorry for my mistake at the correct thing only. X bar is this one. So your divergence of F bar will be equal to how much is it? 5x square.
5x
yeah.
Square.
Yeah. With respect to x, this will be 3x square. This will be x square and this will be again x square. So 5x square you got. So just what we need to do, we need to solve this triple integral of the function 5x square dz dy dx, or any order you write, whichever. Z limits constant, what are the z limits? 0 to b. And what are y limits? If I have written the order y, y limits will be from minus root over of, what is the thing given here? Sorry, it is x square plus y square is equal to a square. So limits of y will be from minus a square minus x square to plus root over of a square minus x square, and x limits will be minus a to plus a. Got it, all of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay, so in any order you can integrate, but here itself, since we are with respect to z, you will just a constant, that b will be out, no problem. But when you integrate with respect to y, the function here, that is with respect to y or x, suppose you will get an even function only, you will get, is it or not? Will you get an even function?
Yes, ma'am, even function.
So, 2 times even function.
2 times.
So, that will be 20, a constant out will be there, 20b. With respect to z, when you integrate, you will get 0 to b as the limits, only b will get. So, 20b I can write. Is it or not? And this limits will be 0 to a, and this limits will be 0 to root power of a square minus x square. If you don't want to observe any of this thing, it's okay. You can directly also integrate and get the result. One by one. I have applied that rule 2 times here itself. One by one also you can apply and solve it. No problem. Here it is x square plus dy dx. So here will be x square actually. When you integrate with respect to y, you will get root over of a square minus x square in multiplication. So that will be 20b integral 0 to a x square root over of a square minus x square dx. Will you? Is it correct?
Yes.
Now integrate this part. So direct application within two line I have written everything. But if you want to go step each and every step, then one by one, you will have to walk more steps in between. So now just simplify this integral, evaluate this integral and tell me the answer. You can convert that into, you can solve this by substitution. Beta gamma functions in the solve change. Or directly also, no need of beta gamma. Directly also you can solve. But you will need the substitution. Substitute x is equal to a sin theta. Are you going for the substitutions? So 20b, x is equal to a sin theta. So I will get a square sin square theta. This will be a square out, root over of 1 minus sin square theta will be cos square theta. So I will just have cos theta there. A cos theta. And dx will be how much? Dx will be a cos theta d theta. So a cos theta d theta. And what about the limits? What substitution? X is equal to a sin theta I have substituted. So as x tends to 0, theta also tends to 0. X tends to a, theta tends to pi by 2. So this will be 20b a square a, so a to the power 4 outside, integral 0 to pi by 2. You have this sin square theta into cos square theta d theta. Since
pi by 4, pi b a power 4.
Come again.
Pi by 4. Pi b a power 4.
Pi b a to the power 4. Correct answer. You have applied beta gamma definition?
No, ma'am.
No, directly. Maybe this you have written it as 20, no? So you can write it as 5 you take out, 4 you can write it as 2 sin theta cos theta whole square. Antana? That's how you have done?
Ma'am, I did cos square theta, 1 minus sin square theta I wrote, ma'am.
Okay.
So integral 0 to pi by 2 sin square theta minus integral 0 to pi by 2 sin power 4 theta.
Okay. So whichever method doesn't matter. Finally, answer should be same for all of us. So one is here itself, you can go for beta gamma functions. That would be damn easy. Or you can write this whole function as 2 sin theta cos theta whole square also. So this will be 1 minus cos 4 theta by 2. You will get something like this. And then again in integral you will get the result. It's your wish how you solve it. No restrictions on that. So this is the answer. What about others? Got it, all of you? No. So this is about Gauss divergence theorem. Note down few more problems. By next class, you try to solve them. And still, if you have any doubt, you can ask. So here they just want you to evaluate f bar dot n bar ds if f bar is xyi plus z square j plus 2yzk over the tetrahedron bounded by x0, y0, z0, and the plane x plus y plus z is equal to 1. So they have not mentioned anything, divergence theorem, verification, or apply that theorem. It's just they want you to evaluate this surface integral. One thing, you evaluate the surface integral itself, or by your own you apply divergence theorem. Okay, so you apply divergence theorem and solve it. That would be very easy. Again, here also I won't mention you apply that theorem, but you apply it and solve it. If you don't want to apply, you solve the surface integral itself. But in particular, if they want you to use that theorem, you will not have any option. So evaluate this integral where f bar is x cube I plus y cube j plus z cube k, and S is the surface of the sphere x square plus y square plus z square is equal to r square. Now here I'm giving a verification. So both you need to do, both the volume and the surface. Verify divergence theorem for x square, 2x square yi minus y square j plus 4xz square k, which is taken over the region of first octant of the cylinder x square plus, okay, it's not x square, it's y square plus z square is equal to 9 and x is equal to 2. Note on these three problems, the above problems written, or should I scroll it? Written these two?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, note on the third one also.
Yes, ma'am.
So there are so many problems like this. You at least try them. So if you have any doubt, you can ask. Otherwise, I'll take the attendance. No doubts?